I'm glad that everybody is joining us again here this evening after two very moving sessions we had this morning with John Byerly. And then later today we had with Johnny Walker Santiago and with Lee Brennan. And if Dan Mullins is indeed back, why don't we go to Steve Litch, who is our chairman of the board. And Steve, you can tell us a little bit about the mission of the American Pilgrims on the Camino and what the American Pilgrims do for the Camino.
Sure. Well, Tom, thanks again for all your creativity and putting this together. It's been a wonderful day so far. And just for those of you who weren't with us for the earlier sessions, just want to remind you what American Pilgrims is all about. Our mission is to foster the enduring tradition of the Camino. And we do that by supporting its infrastructure, by gathering pilgrims together, and by providing information to past and future pilgrims. We support the infrastructure by training hospitaleros, by providing volunteer welcomers to the Ribadiso Albergue, and by making grants through local organizations along the Camino. This year, we made grants of over $78,000 to maintain and improve Donativo Albergues, to develop Camino trails, and to support people in Spain who work to enhance the experience of pilgrims. We gather pilgrims together through our almost 60 local chapters around the country, and also at the annual gathering, which is coming up April 14th through 16th in Lake Tahoe, Nevada. Registration for that is going to open in mid-January. And we provide information through our quarterly online publication, La Concha, through online communities, including our Facebook community, which has over 20,000 members, and our website, which has links to a whole network of resources. And then, of course, these monthly Zoom events that our membership team puts together. Our vision is to inspire all who seek the spirit of the Camino to connect with the global community of pilgrims. And one thing that makes American Pilgrims essential to the pilgrim community in the United States is our connection with the community of pilgrims. We foster relationships with other national associations around the world, sharing ideas and news through a robust correspondence and personal interaction at occasional encuentros that are hosted by associations in Spain. And there's always an international presence at our gathering, from the UK to Spain to Canada, and sometimes even Australia.
That's right. That's right. We had a visit from an Australian at our last gathering in Tahoe. So thank you, Steve. And Steve should let you know that today, in fact, I get an email every time somebody either renews or joins the American Pilgrims. And today has probably been our busiest day of the whole year to get new people that have joined the American Pilgrims or have renewed their membership. And so I want to thank those that have done that with American Pilgrims today. It's very special. And as Steve said, those dollars go to work well to help those needy charitable nonprofit organizations on the Camino with their repairs, maintenance, and infrastructure that help each of us as we go about our pilgrimages in Spain and around the Camino. So Steve, thank you for your inspired leadership. Very much appreciated.
Okay, thanks.
So let's fly off to Australia right now. And we're going to go to Sydney, where it's 30 degrees Celsius. Somebody can figure, I think that's around 80 degrees to 90 degrees Fahrenheit. Sounds like a beautiful day in Sydney, Australia. And we're going to go to the very talented podcast leader, to the Australian songwriter, musician, singer, Dan Mullins. And Dan will talk about his experience on the Camino this past summer with his family. And I think that he might even sing us a few songs during his visit here today. So Dave, if you would be so kind to let everybody see the much better looking Dan Mullins than me, and the much more entertaining Dan Mullins. Dan?
We will see if his video will come up. He's been popping in and out here, so just hold on for 1 minute.
We've been actually pretty fortunate today with the technology.
Dan's there, but he's muted. There he is.
I know, I've got you, I think.
Oh, there you go.
Hear you, Dan.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Screen here in just a moment. And you don't have to worry. The World Cup games are over with for today. And in case if you missed it, France and Morocco were winners today in the World Cup. And Australia and the United States were not part of that, unfortunately, Dan.
No, yeah. We were lucky to get in the first place. So to get into the second round of 16 was just fabulous for us. Yeah. Soccer is very popular in Australia and getting more and more popular, or football, as we try to call it. But we'll do better in time, I think. But look, it's so fantastic to be with you all. Blessings from down under. Yeah, you're right, Tom. It's a beautiful day here. Absolutely glorious. But unfortunately, I can't go out and enjoy it because I have the Rona. I have COVID. And I'm trying to get by as best I can. So if you hear my voice doesn't sound as good as it normally does, there's an excuse, not for the fact that it's Sunday morning, but I had to cancel all my gigs this weekend, which was real. I hate having to do it. In fact, I haven't done it really, I don't think, in 20-something years. So I hope the voice holds out for you all this morning. Tom, do you just want me to talk? Do you want to ask me a few questions? I'm happy just to. I've got some songs prepared and some little bits and pieces prepared. Do you want me to just hit off?
Dan, you're the expert because of your weekly podcasts, and we'll just let you take it away. And if there's time at the end to have people ask live questions, that's a great opportunity. Maybe questions about your Caminos, any inspiring stories that you might want to share and that they'll want to ask about, and any song you want to sing. It's all yours, Dan.
Fabulous. Oh, well, thank you, Tom. And thank you, Steve. And thank you to all of the board and members of the American Pilgrims on the Camino. And I know this is an open house, so I know there's people listening and watching today who aren't members. But as Tom said before, it's been a busy day with everybody signing up. So that's wonderful because it, through my interaction with American Pilgrims on the Camino, I found it to be absolutely fabulous, a wonderful collection of people and very generous and welcoming and I've had some wonderful times with them. I saw snow fall for the first time with the American Pilgrims on the Camino in Lake Tahoe in 2019. That was pre-COVID. And I think that was the weekend that the whole world realized we've got something major going on. So I can't wait to get back to the States. I was on the last plane home out of the United States, the last flight to Australia out of Los Angeles on March 20th. 2020, so right in the heart of it. But let's talk about something more positive than COVID. Let me begin. So thank you again for having me. It's Sunday morning here. Christmas is just around the corner, which is just wonderful. It's a wonderful time of the year here. I have a young Scottish girl working with me at the moment, and she said it's so weird to hear Christmas carols, you know, and jingle bells and stuff in Australia when it's 30 degrees and blazing sunlight outside. She kind of said, it's just so weird, doesn't make sense. And of course it doesn't make sense, jingle bells and riding through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. There's no sleighs around here. You had skateboards and surfboards, but not many sleighs. But Christmas, nonetheless, we celebrate it with all the gusto that is celebrated everywhere else around the world. It's just a little bit different. And Tom, yeah, you're right. I was just so pleased and blessed to finally be able to get out of Australia. We were locked down probably more than any other country other than China. And I, with my wife and two sons and our dear friend Claudette, we were lucky enough to walk the Camino from Villa Franca del Bierzo to Santiago over 10 days in late September. It was the first time my wife had been, the first time my sons had been. It was Claudette's second Camino. And Claudette is a very dear friend who has a very unique story to tell. She lost her daughter when she was 17 years old, and Claudette's never really ever come to terms with it. So the Camino is somewhere, as we often talk about, thin spaces where you feel that the spirit world or a loved ones perhaps you've lost are very close by. And so she really had a very moving experience, and it was wonderful for us to be there, not only to be her support and love and care, but also to know how important we are in each other's lives, our family as well. So we walked and we wondered whether we would walk together or walk apart. And Jennifer, my wife, and I have two, well, I have three sons, but Jen and I have two, 20 and 19, Lewis and Riley. And we started in Via Franca del Biezo, where the town square there, there's a couple of cafes, you know, in the town square. And we had lunch. And then I said, okay, let's put on our packs and we're going to walk. We're only going to walk to Casa Susie's in Trabadello. 15 Ks, 2 hours, maybe 2.5, 3 hours or something. And we crossed the bridge in Via Franca del Biezo. And I said, oh, that's where you go up to the mountains. That's the mountain route up that way. You walk up that little laneway there. And my boys said, oh, we might take the mountain route. So we hadn't even walked together for 5 minutes before they took off. And that was it. We didn't see them again for the rest of the day. So we planned to kind of walk together. It didn't even last more than 5 minutes. But they walked off and we walked off and met up that evening at Casa Susie's, which was just absolutely unbelievable. It was pure magic to see Susie and Fermin. And we've given them, and I know the American Pilgrims on the Camino, many of your members have given a lot of support to Susie and Fermin in trying to get back on their feet. And they are now back on their feet and shining like a new diamond, Casa Susie. And it was just so wonderful to spend some time there. And that was our first night where the boys and Jennifer got to meet other pilgrims and kind of understand what it's like on the Camino. And the other 10 people around the dinner table had walked a long way. One of the couples had come all the way from Le Puy. And so here we were sitting around, and that before dinner, everyone told their story of where they had come from and why they were walking the Camino. And the boys were, I could see that on their faces. They were just so enamored with the whole idea, this concept of, well, look at these people just telling their stories and telling a funny anecdote in there. Or there were people from Missouri and there were people from Albuquerque, and we'd never met anybody from New Mexico before. And this beautiful couple. Missouri, there was a couple there from Missouri. There was a couple of Brits, a couple of Canadian girls, and a couple of Spanish girls. So they got a real mixture on the very first night. And the best part, if I cut straight forward to in Santiago, I did a little gig in Santiago at a bar called Azum, and it was packed, absolutely packed. And here my boys were there, you know, my dad's doing his gig, you know. And in came four of the people, two of the couples that we'd met in Trabadello. And they ran across to my sons, you know, and gave them a big hug. And my boys were so pleased to see them. They had smiles, you know, this huge, huge smiles on their faces. And it was just, as I say, pure magic. And I can't kind of emphasize, I suppose is not the right word, but yeah, maybe it is, just how much love was in the room. There was a lot of love in the room in Trabadello and Casa Susie, a lot of love in other albergues we were in. We quite often stayed in Airbnbs, actually, because we just felt like the whole albergue experience might be a bit much. My wife, Jennifer, is a stroke survivor, so she can't really get very tired. So we had to be mindful of managing her fatigue. And so every second night or third night, we stayed in an Airbnb, which was very reasonable, to be honest, for five people. Very reasonable. And they were tidy. You had your own bed, your own shower, and it was a bit of a kind of an extravagance, but it was necessary. So that's, we kind of did a little bit differently than what I would normally have done in the past. However, it was just absolutely fantastic. So I actually interviewed my sons for my 300th episode of the podcast. I host a podcast, if you don't know, it's called My Camino, the podcast. And I speak to a pilgrim every week from around the world. I've done 305 episodes. I think I've interviewed 300 people. Yeah. And I've done about 3 or 4 or 5 episodes where it's just a reflection, or I maybe play some songs or something. And I was thinking about what I might talk to you about today. And Tom sort of mentioned, maybe Dan, you might touch on the concept of maximizing your Camino. And I thought, well, you know what? I could do that. And we find our best selves on the Camino, and we learn often to love ourselves again. We stop to help someone up, or maybe we pay for someone's lunch, or maybe we give up a bed for someone who's in need, and we listen and we care and we surprise ourselves. And two things you might discover you possess on the Camino, two qualities you perhaps you didn't know, strength and courage. And I saw a quote from Lao Cha. It rang true, and it rang true like a cowbell. He said, being deeply loved by someone gives you strength, while loving someone deeply gives you courage. And I can't help thinking the Camino community is all about love. And you heard from John Brearley today, earlier in the open house. And I spoke to John in August 2019. I can't remember the number of the episode, but here's what he had to say to me here.
When you're on the Camino, it's very few places in the world where you can sit at a cafe at 11 o'clock in the morning and sit down with a total stranger and talk about deep, meaningful, intimate, spiritual matters. I mean, the Camino has that great gift. Mm. We support each other to talk about the things that in a way should really matter, because of course we all have a unique journey to make. I feel as a Caminoite, I feel a very much part of a Camino family. I've never met you, but I know you, and I know you as a brother, and I mean that. Absolutely, Dan. I can honestly say here, the other side of the world, never having met you, I love you.
See, it's amazing, isn't it? The people that you meet. And I interviewed an Australian pilgrim last week, Rosie Jacobs. We'd never met before. She walked the Camino just last month. And I met Rosie in Sydney's World Square. It's really, really busy part of Sydney. And there were hundreds and hundreds of people in the square. And I'd never seen Rosie before. She'd never seen me before. But I picked her straight away. When she sort of came over to me, we had a big hug and people sort of walking by, look at those guys. But we were pilgrims. We kind of share that kind of interesting kind of connection. I want to play for you here. So this is what my son Riley said. He's 19. And this was on my 300th podcast. And this was his reflection or observation from his very first Camino. What surprised you, Riley, about the Camino?
What surprised me most about the Camino were the people. It was so weird to me that we all connected so easily. And I would sit at a cafe and speak to people. And there were people from all around the world. And we had nothing in common except for the Camino and the walk, which I found so incredible. And I loved every minute of it, just meeting new people, hearing their stories, sharing my story. It just surprised me how I was able to click with people so easily.
So Riley is a 19-year-old Australian. He loves rugby league. He loves fishing. He loves his car. He loves his girlfriend. But it was the people and with the people on the Camino that he found his true pilgrimage. This was his big brother Lewis's observation. Now, Lewis is 21 on Tuesday.
Me and my friends, we're at a time in our lives where we're all sort of just leaving home or going out into the workforce or detaching from our parents in a way that we never have before. And also in that, we get the opportunity to realize how much our parents mean to us. When you're younger, like in your teens especially, you go, oh God, you know, can't wait to get out of here, get away from these people, you know. But at 20 something, once you do sort of leave, you go, oh yeah, I'd really love to have a dinner like I did any other night back then. Love to just say hello to dad or mum or whatever and just have that family around.
Did you enjoy meeting people from all around the world, Lou?
The people were remarkable. The people were remarkable. Truly the most impactful thing for me. It was such a range of attitudes, experiences, background. And during something like the Camino, you're in such a hyper-reflective and aware state. You suck up other people's experiences and opinions and cultures like a sponge.
So Lewis has turned 21 on Tuesday. He loves his sneaker collection. He loves his vintage Fender Stratocaster. He loves working out and hanging with his friends. But the Camino provided both of my sons, with this rare insight into what is possible if you allow yourself to be the courage for others and draw strength from others and love. So what's not to love about the Camino? So time for a song. I think I've told you guys before about when I was a boy, my dad brought home a record player And he just bought it. And on the day that they he bought it, they were having a special presentation I don't know what you call it, like an opportunity. And you could choose three albums from the store to take home with you with your new record player. So he took home The Best of Simon and Garfunkel, The Best of the Beach Boys, and Hot August Night by Neil Diamond. So I learned to play all those songs when I was a little boy, like a boy. I was like 11 years old. And then a couple of years later, my big brother Jim brought home a record called Rumours by Fleetwood Mac. And it was probably my young boy thoughts when I first saw Stevie Nicks that had me heading to Spain this year to have to walk through the holy door. I think I learned to play this song when I was 12. I want to play it as a tribute to Christy McPhee, who passed away just last week. This is a beautiful song, yeah.
For you, there'll be no more crying. For you, the sun will be shining. And I feel that when I'm with you, it's all right. I know it's right. To you, I will give the world. To you, I'll never be cold. 'Cause I feel that when I'm with you, it's all right. I know it's right. And the songbirds keep singing like they know the score. And I love you, I love you, I love you like never before. And I wish you all the love in the world. But most of all, I wish it for myself. And the songbirds, they keep singing like they know the score. And I love you, I love you, I love you like never before. Like never before. Like never before. Like never before.
I love that song. And Tom and David and everyone, the American Pilgrims on the Camino team, asked me to touch on maximizing your Camino. Well, I've been thinking lately, all right, so pilgrimage, and a lot of my guests on the podcast have told me that pilgrimage for them is about new beginnings. We walk out our door to explore another part of the world, and we travel in slow motion, providing our heart and our soul with space to soar. And you can take your pick. You can walk the Portuguese, the Norte, the Primitivo, the Camino Madrid. But one thing is certain, you would have surprised yourself with your capability to explore the landscape and culture within, and your inner strength and love. The Camino can provide respite for a troubled soul, a gentle reminder of what's important, or guidance even for a restless spirit. You'll find yourself walking with strangers who become friends, and you'll tell stories you wouldn't tell even your closest friends. And you'll listen to stories that will astonish and inspire you. Your feet carry you, but your heart leads you. And your mind is happy to be led by the whispering of your inner self. What a joy. What a blessing. This love. So we, on our last Camino, stayed in a little place called the Hostel León in León. If you know the road that leads up the toward the cathedral, the cafes on the right-hand side, take you back, tuck yourself back there for a minute. You've got the Gaudi building on the left and the, I think it's the Parliament there on the other side and the fountain at the back behind you. And those cafes on the right-hand side, there's a little bakery there that does sensational cafe con leche, and they always give you a little churros when you leave. And we were on the balcony of the albergue, which is on the corner of the street that leads you down to the Roman ruins and some nice cafes down there. And I was on the balcony sitting there, and this song came on the I don't know if it was a playlist or the radio or whatever. And I thought straight away, oh, this is a Camino song if ever I've heard one. And I'd totally forgotten about it until just a couple of days ago. I was driving home from work and it came on the radio and I thought, oh, that's right. And the memory took me straight back to that little balcony in León. And I thought, I must play that on Sunday for the American pilgrims on the Camino. Because it's just so great. It's so great. Let me see. Here we go. You sheltered me from harm, kept me warm, kept me warm. You gave your life to me, set me free, set me free. Here we go. The finest years I ever knew were all the years I had with you. And I will give everything I own, give up my life, my heart, my home. I will give everything I own just to have you back again. You told me how to love, what it's all, what it's all. You never said too much, still you showed the way. And I knew from watching you, nobody else could ever know part of me that can't let go. I would give in, I own, give up my life, my heart, my home. Yeah, I will give everything I own just to have you back again. Is there someone you know, you're loving them so, and they're taking it all for granted? You may lose them one day, someone takes them away, and they don't hear the words you want to say. I will give anything I own, give up my life, my heart, my home. I will give everything I own just to have you back again, just to have you back again. Isn't that a great song? Such a great song. Bread, well, can't cook much better than that. So I was mentioning earlier that Christmas is here, and we've just got a small family Christmas here this year. We sadly lost my wife's mum just a couple of weeks ago. In fact, the day I got back from Canada, I've been in Canada doing some shows, and I got back and the dad hadn't even got off the tarmac, and I got a call to say that Joyce had died. And so it was 2 weeks then of chaos and fatigue and jet lag and everything else. But we got through it, and now we're going to have a Christmas, a time of giving and a time of kindness, which is really something to look forward to for each of us to share with each other. And the other thing about or the other joy, I suppose, of us gathering here at the American Pilgrims on the Camino's open house is that we get the chance to talk about maximizing the Camino as part of being kind to yourself. And what I've been through these last few months, it's all about being kind to yourself. We've seen the epidemic, really, of mental health issues and people struggling with anxiety and anger and depression and heartache and not finding their equilibrium, not being able to find their steady or their happy place. And knowing you deserve what's best physically and spiritually is really a goal we should all strive for, everyone, young and old, fit and unfit. And the Camino is a really good place to do it. You'll see all types on the Camino, all religions, all colors, and everyone's welcome. And the great thing about walking the Camino and becoming a pilgrim is that you sign up for and love a simple life. You carry a pack on your backs, change of clothes, maybe some toiletries, maybe a phone charger or two, a notebook and some water, and off you go. You go exploring, you go discovering, go live. And one of the key discoveries of pilgrimage is the chance to disconnect from your usual day-to-day life. And there's a freedom you experience on the Camino, which is very rare in our daily grind. That's the blessing, if you ask me, of St. James the Stronger, right there. Freedom. Freedom to explore. Freedom to discover. Freedom to live. To roam this wonderful world. You wouldn't believe my luck that just after that bread song was played, this song came on. And I said, I've never actually played this song before. So I have only thrown the words and the chords into this document I've got here in front of me as a prompt for talking to you today. So I hope I do it justice, especially with the sore throat and the COVID and everything. But when it came on after the other song in the car coming home from work, it's not often I'll sit in the car and listen to a song when I get home, but you know, I still sat out there with the car running for a couple of minutes before I went inside to hear the end of it. And I just had to play it for you guys today. I knew I had to. So I've got the words and the chords right here, which I never ever do. So here we go. I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I got that. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, sun blessed day, dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of the people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies crying. I watch them grow. They'll learn much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yeah, I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I thought that went okay, COVID and all. I had the most incredible stroke of good fortune by mistake this week. Let me have a glass of water. Gas and electricity prices in Australia are going through the roof, as I'm sure they are in the States, America, everywhere. And I'm executive producer of one of the leading news podcasts in Australia. That's my day job. And I was writing to someone about solar power. And instead, my autocorrect said soul power, S-O-U-L power. And I didn't notice it until later in the day. And I read it back and I was like, oh, soul power. Okay, Daniel, keep an eye out for yellow arrows next. You're back on the Camino. Soul power. So I Googled soul power, right? And the first thing that came up was a quote from a book called Soul Cure, How to Heal Your Pain and Discover Your Purpose by Gregory Dickow, who's the lead pastor of the Life Changes Church in Illinois in the United States. Listen to this for a quote. Soul power ripples outward in all directions, affecting everything: physical health, emotional well-being, relationships, families, work, and destiny. And that's freedom. And you're powered by soul power on the Camino. The soul power. I love it. And it's such a great way to think of how to maximize your Camino. Tap into your soul power. And when I was putting all of this together over the last 10 days or so, I was thinking about mainly about love, right? And I wanted to play a love song for you. And I've played a couple, I guess, already. And I got to thinking about love songs. And my little brother Ben wrote a love song in 1987. And he recorded it in 1988 with a band called The Benedicts. And my other little brother, Leo, was in the band. So two brothers and a friend of ours, Tim, who's still a very, very dear friend. And they were in a band. They recorded this song called Simple in 1988. Yeah. It's the only recording of the song. I still have it. But their harmonies on that song were just so beautiful. The sentiment of the song is so beautiful. It's such a beautiful love song. And the most striking part about it is the harmonies. Leo sang harmonies on it. And I still sing the song from time to time. It's a wonderful love song. And the three of us sang together for years. And I don't think anyone can sing harmonies like a brother. And I say sang and harmonies together and not sing harmonies together because both of them have now passed away. Leo died 2 years ago from cancer. He was 49. And Ben died in 2010. He was 42. So when I was thinking of love songs to sing you, I couldn't go past this. And if you listen closely, you might just hear some brothers singing harmonies together. Hold on.
No, I don't understand why you cry. There's boys out there with chisel chins. Here's a man who had no pride. He had no pride. And I know that she died peacefully. And all you could have done is try. And I hope like hell that you survived, you survived. After this I could have cried a thousand tears of hope. How will I ever be simple again? How will I ever be simple again? I know it's over. That much is true. How will I? charms. And I had a ring from Ireland. Then you bought me a Russian band, a Russian band. How will I ever be simple again? How will I ever be simple again? I know it's over.
The Benedicts and my little brothers. It's nice to sing along with them again. We sang harmonies together for years. We played in bands, but inevitably when brothers play in bands together, they end up fighting. We had some fights that stopped traffic in the street. But that's, you know, wild colonial boys kind of stuff. which I'm not proud of, shouldn't be proud of. But singing harmonies, singing songs, sharing stories is just a joy of mine and love of mine. I'm pretty sure you can tell I really enjoy it. Maximizing your Camino, just touching off on that now. Why not write some songs? Why not write anything? Write a book? Why not draw some pictures? Try singing. Write a play about the Camino. Write a letter. Write a blog. Maximize this new you. This courageous and generous you. And I was feeling particularly inspired, strong and courageous, I guess. I was just outside Azua. This is 2 months ago. My sons and I had just walked 27 kilometers together, and we drifted apart from time to time, sure, and then regathered, and we watched a pilgrim in front of us at one stage picking up a stone and putting it on top of the way markers. And I explained to my sons, their prayers. That's a form of leaving your prayer behind on the Camino, sort of way that you can do that. And they thought that was, you know, well, okay, a prayer. Well, that's interesting, Dad. And then later, as we sort of drifted apart and I was back a little bit further, I saw one of the boys pick up a stone and place it on a marker. And I thought, well, if that's the only blessing I get from this last 10 days of walking together, then that'll do me just about forever, I guess. And that afternoon they were sleeping, the boys. My wife and Claudette were resting, and I wandered into town. I love Azura, the town square where the pollarded trees make the canopy there. I was talking to a couple of American pilgrims, actually, and we were getting on famously, and they sort of drifted away and left me, and I went into the bar and bought a beer and was sitting out under the trees, a beautiful sunny day. And I thought, you know what? I should just quickly write something for the boys. I don't know why, because I had this feeling, well, I'd love to leave a blessing for them. So I wrote in one fell swoop, may you stand tall when others fall. Use your words wisely and listen. For another's words, you will learn, and use what you learn to do good and be good. For goodness is worth sharing. And your heart is for caring.
I think we lost him there, Tom. We'll give him a second. We'll try to get him back on here.
And what a moment to lose him.
Right.
What an inspirational.
That was amazing.
Such a person to share with us all the way from Australia on his Sunday afternoon there now. And Dan is a special American pilgrim. He came to our gathering, as we all remember, in Lake Tahoe in March of 2020. And he said it was his first snowfall. So we got to share that together, but we share so much more as he was sharing with us this evening. So, you know, it's I guess it's the membership director, Dan, and me that may take this moment here to ask everybody if you aren't a member of the American Pilgrims, you can easily go to AmericanPilgrims.org and hit the join us button. And I can see talking about joining us that Dan, you're back. You're joining us again.
But am I on my side on?
No, you're sideways.
I'm okay.
Dan is sideways.
You won't believe this, right? I've got do not disturb on my phone. But Tom and David, for everybody listening and watching, Tom and David and I did a test run yesterday, and I was on my side for the whole time. And so we had to try all these different ways to get me in landscape, right? And so I rang my son, the very person I'm talking about right now, and I've got my phone on do not disturb. He's obviously, and I tried to ring him earlier just to make sure I was doing everything right. And he's obviously seen the call because he's away for the weekend. And said, "Oh, Dad needs me, so I'll ignore his do not disturb and call." And his call just booted me off the meeting. So there you go. So, so am I in the right profile? Is everything working?
You're still sideways, and so you're there, and you've written this about
Okay, so I wrote this thing. So may you stand tall when others fall short. Use your words wisely and listen. For in others' words, you will learn and use what you learn to do good and be good. For goodness is worth sharing and your heart is for caring. Like footsteps, this journey, life is preparing you to be your best self. Do what is right. Kiss your children each night. Love without reason and cherish the seasons. For you will grow like the harvest. And so, fullness for others, as you have discovered love. Your time to shine, and in your heart, time to be better forever. Love, Dad. And love is fleeting, yet kind in a way, just like us pilgrims. I want to sing a song for you now. If you haven't heard the story, I was walking on the Meseta in 2017.
And as you do this, could I just say that you are still sideways, and a few people have turned their phone sideways to be able.
Oh no! Are you saying am I the right way up or not?
You're not. You're not. You're sideways.
Oh, I thought I was right.
No.
Oh, how annoying for you all.
There. Very good.
Is that fixed? It.
Yes, you're fixed.
Okay. So sorry. So I'm in the Meseta 2017. I'm walking with sticks because I was carrying this guitar on my back. If you've never seen it before, in 2017, I carried the guitar, and instead of getting stamps in a credential, I got them on the guitar. You can see it. Yeah. It's all beat up now. It's probably not long for this world, this little guitar. So out on the Camino, I'm walking, and the click, click, click of the sticks on the ground made a sound like a metronome, like that. And I was thinking, oh, that's really, and I always walk when I sing. I always sing when I walk. I sing when I walk. And I'm out on the Meseta in the middle of nowhere, and I'm just singing whatever comes into my head. And I start singing, somewhere along the way, I hope you find what you're looking for, somewhere along the way. And I thought, what song's that? And if I've told this story before, forgive me. I went into town that night. I wrote out the words in one fell swoop. And I came back to Australia. Well, that night I played it for some pilgrims and they loved it. And everyone was singing it. And I kept singing it all the way along the Camino. And by the end of the Camino, a few weeks later, people were singing it to me when I walked into the square in Santiago. I've played it in people's lounge rooms. I've played it in cafes, in bars, in concert halls. I've played it in television. I've played it on the radio. I've played it twice at the Prime Minister's house in Sydney, here in Australia. I've just come back from a series of talks and shows in Canada. And I'd like to think a tour of the US maybe is not far off, perhaps even just around the corner. This is called Somewhere Along the Way, the Camino song. And sing along if you feel the love and you feel courageous and generous.
Seven bells to four, frighten off the horses, and all soul awaits a lion's heart, an open it heart, and a soul as old as slave.
Here we go.
Somewhere along the way, somewhere along the way. You're looking for somewhere along the way. Cellos on a soundboard, beneath a field of stars, la familia growing, crossing fields afar. Will you walk beside me? Will you lead the way? Footsteps by the fountain, oh, they carry me away. Somewhere along the way, somewhere along the way. I hope you find what you're looking for, somewhere along the way. How will I ever forget the Spanish sunrise? Spanish sunset. El peregrino cantante, fullness of the moon, breaths beneath the arches, and sunflowers in bloom. Words on parchment paper, fill an empty room. This blessing, such as it is, finds you in full bloom. Somewhere along the way, somewhere along the way, I hope you find what you're looking for, somewhere along the way.
One more time.
Somewhere along the way.
Buen Camino.
Somewhere along the way, you're looking for somewhere along the way.
So thank you all so much for inviting me to be part of your open home. Next time I'll bring a plate, as my mother used to say. I always love being part of any celebration hosted by the American Pilgrims on the Camino. It's such a blessing. And from this humble pilgrim down under, thank you, Tom. Thank you, David. Thank you, everybody. And buen camino.
So Dan, you know, we are doing the American Pilgrims National Gathering, or we can say if you would come, it would be an international gathering at Tahoe, and it will be April, I believe, the 13th through the 16th. And I hope that you can find a way of coming and joining us. Wow. I promise to you, Dan, that if it snows, I'll throw you a snowball.
Yeah, that's right. You threw the first ever snowball at me, and that's right. But I'd love to. I'll have to have a think about it. I was planning on heading maybe to walk the Primitivo in late April, so maybe I could stop off on the way.
Stop off somewhere along the way. You could stop off.
Exactly. Exactly.
That would be awesome. And then maybe then on your other way back, you can stop by and you can do your American tour. And I'm sure that we could get an audience for you. I know in South Bend, Indiana, or Chicago, or anywhere around the country that we've got American pilgrims.
Well, that's what we just did in Canada. Each of the chapters of the Canadian Company of Pilgrims hosted a gathering. So they used the opportunity to do a shell ceremony and talk and meet new members, and then I would do a two and a quarter hour show.
We don't want everybody to know this, but we can share this with just the folks that are here on this open house tonight, that Dave and Tom from the Canadian Pilgrims are working on putting together an international gathering. The two organizations, the American Pilgrims on the Camino and the Canadian Pilgrims, are looking at putting together an international gathering in 2025, and that would be in Vancouver. And so that's something to be looking forward to, an international gathering here in North America.
Fantastic.
We should also let people know, and you get the secret word here, everybody, is that if you wish to go to the gathering in April, believe it or not, you have to register early because there are a limited number of people that can attend. Dan, you know firsthand that it's not a huge place, but it's really a beautiful place. And registration opens up, I believe, at 8 a.m. on Saturday, January the 14th. So mark January the 14th on your calendars if you wish to get that secret early registration in for the gathering coming up. So there's a lot of interesting things for the American Pilgrims. And Dan, did you want to take just a couple of live questions? Are you feeling okay? I know you've got COVID. I could see that you're grimacing when you're swallowing.
No, I'm fine. I'm fine. I'm happy to take questions. Yeah, that's, I thought I'd leave 10 minutes for that, but we're sort of running out of time, but let's do it. That'd be great if anybody's got a question.
If you would raise your hand, the electronic hand. Lynn Kay, you're the first one again to ask a question. Lynn Kay, you're on.
Hi, Dan. Thank you so much. It was wonderful to hear you. And I'm sorry you got COVID. I got COVID right at the end of this year's pilgrimage in Camino Portugués, and it was miserable. So I'm sorry you've got it too now. I'm going to be moving to Portugal, and Johnny Walker said that you knew some people who had moved or were setting up an albergue in Portugal
thing. And, yeah, Tanya Valdez, yeah.
I'm sorry?
Her name is Tanya Valdez. And Lynn, there's actually an episode of my podcast. If you just Google My Camino, the podcast, Tanya Valdez, V-A-L-D-E-S. She was an American who moved to Portugal and opened an albergue. Yeah.
Okay, great.
Dan, I'm trying to remember. Wait, do you remember the number of the episode, Dan? No.
I don't. I don't know the number of the episode, but it would take me like literally 1 minute to find it while we're just sitting here. And she's on the coast too, Lynn.
Tanya's
place. Yeah, she's on the coast, so it's spectacularly beautiful.
Podcast and all of your podcasts are great. While you're doing that, I see Tom from Canada is in Canada. And we'll get back to that though, Lynn. Tom, are you actually in Santiago?
I have a view of the cathedral, but they've turned the lights down at 3 o'clock in the morning. I don't know why, but I just wanted to bring a greeting from the other side of the world to Dan and thank him for his trip to Canada. Dan's a triple threat. You know, he does pub shows, he does talks like he gave tonight, and he also does a presentation centered around the Camino. And we really had a good time with him in London, Hamilton, Toronto, and Ottawa, and parts between. So nice to see you, Dan. I'm hoping you get back from the COVID pretty quick.
Thank you, Tom. It's so lovely to hear your voice. My gosh, what a blessing. How was the Camino?
Well, I was working as an hospitalero, so I was in Ponferrada, and I had up to 50 pilgrims, and the glory of it was that I came to Santiago to walk to the sea, but I ended up hanging around Santiago, and I kept bumping into pilgrims every day we had served in the morning, served in Ponferrada, which is 210 kilometers back. So a week after we serve them, they arrive in town. And inspiration by singing, we sing them awake in the morning. So morning has broken, Altrea song, and Gracias a la Vida was up and down the halls as they woke up at 7 o'clock in the morning, and big smiles when they woke up. Great experience.
Oh, how lovely to hear your voice. Congratulations, Tom. Oh, I can't wait. We'll be in touch. We'll be in touch. How fantastic. And thank you for your kind words, Tom. I really appreciate it.
Is there another live question out there? You just put your hand up and we'll post that. If not, just unmute yourself and ask a question, but one person at a time, please. If not, okay. Dan, do you have, Sarah said she was going to bring her guitar and Tom's there to sing that, but that doesn't work on Zoom, does it, too well?
Dan? No, because of the delay. Delay makes it really difficult. It doesn't really work. Oh, that's a shame. I hope Sarah's well. I look forward to seeing Sarah potentially. I could potentially give you an answer by mid-January, Tom, so that you could promote my visit as part of the event next year. I'll have to just do a little bit of research and a little bit of juggling, but I think I might, fingers crossed, be able to at least have a think about getting there.
So we do have Sarah on here, and we should share Sarah with Dan that at the last gathering that we had at Black Mountain, North Carolina in March, we had many people from the American Pilgrims sit around playing guitars and other instruments and singing songs around the campfire in the evening. And we sang Somewhere Along the Way many times.
Oh, fabulous.
Fond memories of you, wishing that you were here. Sarah, did you want to share something with us today?
I just wanted to say, Dan, thank you so much. You've been an inspiration to so many of us. And I know I'm not the only one who either has a ukulele, a banjo, or a guitar and plays that song regularly. So we'd love to have you at the gathering again in Lake Tahoe. And I can even teach you how to make a snow angel if we're so lucky to have snow and you in Tahoe in April.
Thank you, Sarah. Oh, how lovely. It would be just such a delight to see you all again. I'll do my very, very best. And I still get messages, emails, and from all around the world, from people wanting the chords and the words to that song. And it's on my website, Dan Mullins Music. There's a PDF there. I think it's under the music drop-down menu. There's the song and the words and the chords are all there. Anyone who sings that song is, I think, it's just a blessing to have people around the world singing your songs. It's just fantastic. I love it so much. So thank you. And Lynn, it's episode 193 where I interviewed Tanya Valdez about her albergue in Portugal. Episode 193.
Great. Hopefully down the road, you can also be a hospitalero, Dan, and sing people awake with that song at the albergue that you would be stationed at to be a hospitalero at. In Ponferrada. And how the Dutch hospitaleros in Roncesvalles, they come through and they They sing Everyone Awake at 6:30 in the morning, which is that beautiful monastery there just on the other side of the Pyrenees, just past that Mary statue that you wrote a song about.
That's right.
So, well, Dan, thank you again. Do you have one last song in you with your sore throat, or should we stop here sort of let it end right now as on the special note?
No. Let me. Actually, you know, just 2 nights ago, The Way was on our the equivalent of our ABC, our Australian Broadcasting Corporation. And I remember the morning after he meets the girl who smokes, remember, and she calls him Boomer, and they talk about the iPod. And she says, "Good luck, Boomer," and says, "Good luck with your James Taylor." And I'd forgotten totally that they play a little snippet of this. I'll play it for you. I think I can remember it.
Walking down the highway, won't you, good boys and girls? Your way and my way seem to be one and the same. I can see a heavenly band full of angels, and they're coming to set me free. Don't know nothing about the why or when, but you can tell me that I'm bound to see. But you know you can feel it, child, yeah. On a country road. At home.
Oh, no, I shouldn't have started playing if I don't remember the words. Oh, yeah.
Take to the highway, won't you lend me your hand? Your man and my way seem to be one and the same. Mama don't understand it. She wants to know where I've been. I have to be some kind of natural born fool to want to pass this way again. But you know I can feel it, child, yeah. On a country road. I think my feet know where they want me to go. Walking on a country road. La 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 country road, yeah, yeah, walking on a country road, country road.
I think I got the verses back to front. Anyway, it doesn't matter.
You've touched our hearts this evening, and you touch them every week with your My Camino podcast, and all you do for the Camino, it is inspiring. And we thank you for joining us today, and we hope to do this again sometime again very soon.
And I look forward to it. I look forward to it, and I really, really appreciate and love being invited to be part of your celebrations, your open homes, your gatherings. It means the world to me. So thank you so much. Thank you so much, Tom. And thanks, David. And thanks, everybody, Sarah and everybody at the American Pilgrims on the Camino. I really appreciate it. Buen Camino, everyone.
Buen Camino.